Okay, so this video is all about check-in. Yeah, check-in. So, your guys' check-in date, most of your guys' check-in date, is Monday, right? The 8th? Then some of you guys come in the 7th, I don't know, the 27th? Well, some of them. But, okay, guys' side of check-in, you cannot have long, straggly beard. It has to be trimmed half inch from your face, and it cannot be like down here only. It has to be a full beard. You cannot have goatee. You cannot have like your little mustache beard collection. I do know one of my coworkers has that, but since he's seasonal, he's only going to be here for like a month, I guess they're letting him slide. If you grow beards really rapidly, and one day you won't have a beard, but the next day you'll have stubble, you have to shave that stubble. Or they will give you a crappy razor and a bottle of shaving cream for you to fix it. For girls, on check-in, because most of it's girl type thing, you have to have your hair one color. No bottom layer black, top layer blonde, or dark brunette or something like that. All one color. You have to have Disney look. This is Disney look. You can have a sweatshirt on. You cannot have a tube top. You cannot have a tank top. You cannot have one that goes over your shoulder, only one shoulder. You have to have a full, like, either full top, or you can have a shawl, something like that. Because you're going to have your ID taken for your housing, and it has to be Disney look. It has to be. You can, if you have, it goes both ways for guys and girls. If you have an afro, it has to be either trimmed, very, very short trim, or you can corn roll it. Because that's how Disney does not like afros, I guess, because it's not clean. Disney is a clean cut type thing. Like guys can have long hair. Guys can have as long hair as I do. Or you can have longer hair, but you always have to have it tied back. Always. At all times. Tied back. At any time of the day. And if you're working, it's tied back. Just tell you. But your check-in time, it probably starts at 8 o'clock and then ends at noon. I do recommend coming earlier than 8 o'clock, probably about 7:30, because that line for check-in will be very, very, very long. I remember my first check-in, and I went there at 7:30 in the morning, and the line wasn't that long for me, but it was still pretty long for everyone else. And the quicker you get in line, the quicker you can get your paperwork done at casting services. And that paperwork takes 3 hours to do. 3 hours. You get to go all throughout the casting building because you go through different parts. It's great. Also, check in. First thing you need to get your state ID. Not your school ID, your state ID. Either ID or driver's license, permit, whatever you guys have. You need that. Doesn't matter what else. You need that right there. You also need either your birth certificate or your social security card. You can bypass these two and just bring your passport. But even if you bring your passport, you do need your ID. Your state ID. Just to tell you. I brought both of my birth certificate and my social security card just in case they needed it. Like if one wasn't sufficient enough. Spot on both, just to tell you. I know you guys are probably finishing packing up right now, but that's what I brought. Don't forget that. And basically, just come to have fun. Don't worry, check-in's not going to be the death of you, especially when you move into an apartment.